When you shine the light in the dark, there's people who want to stay in the dark.
There's been plenty of people, specifically on YouTube, the internet, that they're talking out of both sides of their mouth about Jeet Kune Do because it's a controversial topic to get more views on a video, to either sell some kind of training program or get more ad dollars. And as you referred, there's always money and business involved. And there's agents that are going to act well, and they're going to sell a service that's worth something. And there'll be people that gain value from that service. That's the basics of economics. And you'll have bad agents that perhaps are selling something that isn't worth what it says, or create confusion for attention in this case to sell whatever their agenda is. And really, this is get attention, get eyeballs on something that is controversial, create confusion along the way, but it hurts the martial art that this awesome mind created. So the martial arts community suffers when people do things like that. And honestly, it offends people like myself and you who have dedicated our lives, you more than me, because you're obviously older and you were closer to the core of it. But honestly, it offends me because I spend my life dedicating to this craft, and I have people on the internet that don't know what they're talking about, and people are listening to them.
You've been doing it for quite a while, because I've known you since you was like knee-high to a grasshopper, right? I'm coming up to 50 years in this, so imagine how I feel about it. First of all, some people feel that in order to advance themselves, they got to diminish other people. That's a pretty poor example. Is the only way I can make myself look good is to try and make somebody else look bad.
You know, I called out Sensei Seth and Icy Mike and this guy at Stoll. I said, guys, you're talking about Jeet Kune Do. And honestly, I'll say Sensei Seth is a good practitioner. I don't think Icy Mike and Ed Stoll are that good, but as practitioners. But what I'm saying is you guys are calling out things that you don't know about. Sensei Seth, you know about karate. You clearly do. You're showing real karate stuff. I even complimented Ed Stoll. I said, yo, you're doing trapping live. Look. But I'll also dial back and saying that some of these agents online are purporting a lot of misconceptions. And then they're throwing out buzzwords like classification.
You now have people who give belts and sashes in Jeet Kune Do. You can get a black belt in Jeet Kune Do, which to me is the very antithesis of what it is all about. It doesn't mean they're not good martial artists, and it doesn't mean that this person might not be advocating some things. But I just look at it and I go, why?
And I'm gonna say one last thing, and I don't mean this in a disrespectful way. I mean this as respectfully as possible. Jeet Kune Do is about pressure testing and sparring, and I'll politely move around with any one of them. And if you beat me up, that's fine. It will not disprove Jeet Kune Do. It will just show that, hi, here's a move. That's a Jeet Kune Do move. Here's a principle, and here's it in action. But they just want to talk on the internet and talk bad about Jeet Kune Do, but don't actually want to pressure test anything. I'm sorry.
Well, you know, again, you've got to go back and look at who's doing the talking and what they're talking about and why they're talking about it.